Hello everyone, welcome to Oracle FM channel. In this video, we are going to see Tracefile Analyzer. And how to diagnose the Oracle database issues. Overall database performance issues. How to do in a single command. How to diagnose and how to collect all the logs across the nodes. So let me log into the server. Cluster services running on SRLab rack 1 and SRLab rack 2, but the DB sub rack 1 node only. So here, so the instance is SRLab-1 is running on node 1, SRLab rack 2, online relocation inactive. Okay, so it is one node rack. So I'm going to build at the DB performance. So if you are facing any database performance issue, what we will do? We will collect the, we will run the AWR report and best run like previous date, previous day AWR and present day AWR. We will run a compare AWR report and ADDM report and ASH report. Everything we will check and analyze what is the cause of this database performance. So what is the issue? So we will collect all those things in manually. But now, in a single command, we can collect all the details through Tracefile Analyzer, TFA, command. So this is what we are going to see right now. Let me log into the database here. So I'm going to check the TFA status and version. Now TFA CTL version. TFA CTL status. So it's giving one, like TFA software is older than 180 days. Please consider upgrading TFA to the latest version. Yes, of course. The TFA software will be released every 3 months. So we need to update in my next video. I am going to demonstrate how to upgrade that TFA software. Reversion. And now what I am going to do, so the DB is running here. Is the DB is running, so I am observing the database performance is a bit slow, like it's not performing well. So I am observing some performance issues in this DB. So usually what we will do, like we will run that, we will collect all the information from OEM, that is AWR report, ASH report and the ADM, and all the reports run on each node, and we will collect the compare report as well, and we will compare previous good day performance, debut performance and present day the issue snapshot during the snapshot time debut performance. We will compare and we will make the we will take the action according to that issues, and is there any CPU spike or memory leak or memory spike, any CPU bottlenecks, so or else in the database level how many inactive sessions. So everything will collect in the manually through the TAWR and IDDM report. So we will analyze it and we will send it. If it is not affected by ourselves, and we will send this report to Oracle support, and they will give a solutions or workaround for this database performance issue, and we will work on like this way. But in this case, TFA case, a single command will do all the things. So now I am going to execute this command, dia collect -srdc dbfer. So it will collect in the single command, it will gather all the information across the nodes. So first it will do node 1 and database performance, and again it will collect the node 2, and there will be a database performance. So in both the instances, it will collect and cumulatively collect the two zip files, and node 1 zip files and node 2 zip files across in this repository location. So now I am giving database name. So it will start collecting the database performance issues, problems, everything in there on zip file. And this zip file, we will analyze it. And if suppose we want to upload to Oracle support, then we can upload those zip files to Oracle support. Through TFA-CTL, through the trace filter analyzer itself, we can upload those zip files, provided that we will configure the mail settings. I mean, Oracle support mails settings. We need to enable, we need to configure, then we can upload to MyTallink site. So I am giving one day, otherwise we need to give that provide some other time range. So I don't have any SQL ID, I am just giving that, leave it blank and enter. Here it is, that found one snapshot for bad performance time range in SRLab. Found 0 snapshot for baseline range in SRLab. So error, no snapshot exists for baseline time range and database SRLab. Please select AWS snapshot exists for the baseline good performance time range. For because of, why? Because of this is asking for compare report, AWS compare report. According to repository, it is a licensed feature. So that is you know. And scripts to be run by this SRDC like Voracek, check DBFab is IPS Pack, db slow, SRDC db, if, lfs, dir.sql. These are the scripts will be executed in this run. Components included in this SRDC, OS, CRS, database, chmos. So these are the components going to analyze and collect the diagnostic report will be gathered for this components. We can log in this location, we can look at this log. Any file or directory name containing string.com will be replaced with dp.com with the .com. Collection name, this is the collection name, this is the zip file. All the trace files and the log files will be put into this zip file. Collecting diagnostic from host SRLab rack 2 and SRLab rack 1. Scanning files for collection in progress. Collection additional diagnostic information. So now it started collecting to the host level. Next, CRS and then database and then chmos. So now the diagnostic collection got completed successfully. So it is collected across the nodes and the scanning of files for collection in progress is completed and diagnostic information, getting list of files, status being the time range. So collecting incident files, it's all completed on local node and the remote node as well. So completed collection of additional diagnostic information, completed local collection and remote collection in progress. So it is collection summary, SLR rack 2 and SLR rack 4 completed. Its size is a zip file, both the zip file size 22 MB and 25 MB each. So logs are being collected in this location for SLR rack 1. This is for node 1, node. This is for rack node 1, this is for rack node 2. This both the zip files. So we need to validate, analyze these log files for the TP performance issues for this vulnerability search cost. And these zip files we need to upload to Oracle support site for the analysis and workaround and solutions. So that's all, my friends. Thanks for watching Oracle FM channel. Please do subscribe and share across your DB networks.